Absolutely. And one of the wonderful speakers you'll be able to speak to in the atrium later is Edna Adden. Now, we were lucky enough to get to meet her yesterday, and she completely blew us away. Here are just some of the amazing things this woman has done. She was the first Somali woman to drive. She's been foreign minister in her homeland. She's built her own hospital, and now, as well as running that, she's actually running her own university. She's really bringing to life that theme of today, investing in young people and hypercharging action. It's fair to say that there's a lot that we can all learn from her. So to close this session, please join me in giving a very big welcome to the stage, Edna Adden.
Hello, everyone. What a day we've had. I know I've had the best day of my life. The energy in this hall and the wisdom that was coming out of the people today was so amazing. And I say, thank God I lived to see to be 81, to live this. Imagine if I had died at 80, I wouldn't have had this. And the wonderful encouragement and the commitments that I've heard. The commitments from President Macron. Environment. Where would we be without environment? Education. You wouldn't be here without education. You'd still be carving things on a stone. Health. Where would we be without health? We're here because we're healthy, because we can think, because it gives us opportunity to use our bodies, our minds, our skills, our time. But how many people have that in the world? We heard about the commitment of Sierra Leone, technology. We heard about the plight of refugees. And that hurts a lot because I come from Somaliland, the poorest country in the world, one that doesn't even feature on your maps. We don't have a flag out there. We don't exist. But we have over 17 or 18,000 refugees in Somaliland who we host, who we protect, who we feed, who we educate, who we treat. And we don't treat just a simple cold or a diarrhea. Children in the Horn of Africa, whether in Somalia or Somaliland, Djibouti, and parts of Ethiopia, who are born with hydrocephaly, water on the brain, do you know where they go for treatment? They don't have a passport. They don't have visas. They can't go anywhere else. Do you know where they go for treatment, where their parents bring them? They bring them to Somaliland. To Somaliland? To put a shunt in the brain? In Somaliland? Now, where are the neurosurgeons in Somaliland who can do that, who are willing to go to Somaliland to go and operate on children? Operated on by a young woman who herself was a refugee, who taught herself to read on sand. Do you say, why could she not learn on a what do you call it, you know, the tablet or paper or pencil? She didn't have that. She learned to teach herself to read on sand, as you do on the beach. You do designs. That's how our children taught themselves to read. That child, refugee camp, sitting in the shade of a tree because there were no schools, was one of the first 306 young girls who applied to my nursing school in 2000. And we interviewed them, and we had them sit for entrance exams in maths and biology and chemistry. These are subjects I need that candidate to know and to have and to have learned if I'm going to train them to become nurses tomorrow and calculate doses and treatments. And when we had 42 who passed the exams, the top 40, I had them sit there, and there was a little girl on the third row, and I said, by the way, what's that girl doing in the third row, the little one, the one between the girl in the green dress? And I said, oh, she's one of the 42 who passed the exams. And I said, but she's a kid, she's a baby, my goodness, she's going to take space that could have been used by an older person. Anyway, she held on to her position. She excelled in her studies. She grew taller, almost by the minute. She's taller than I am now, which isn't hard because I'm only 5'1½". But she grew and she retained her position. She passed the midwifery exam and she was so good, I sponsored her medical education. And she graduated as a medical doctor in 2011. And she was trained by a neurosurgeon who came to us from North Carolina every 6 weeks to train her. That young girl, who I almost kicked out, who was too small, too young to become a nurse, is today a neurosurgeon who has operated on over 500 children. So, that teaches you, I hope that gives you that message, that your potential is limitless. What I would like you to take away today is that you should have that confidence in yourself, that determination to want to do what you believe in and what you wish to do. And don't forget that if achievements like the ones that I've given you, that example, can happen in Somaliland, the sky's the limit. But first, do your homework. When you wish to do something, plan, study, analyze. Pick up your best options. What resources do you have? What is the size of the problem? How are you going to approach that problem? Study, analyze, look at your options. Find allies. Never go into a battle on your own if you can have allies who are like-minded. And I feel today that I have been given the most difficult task to summarize what had been said today. It's like putting a great ship into a little matchbox. But I feel that you're the future of this planet. I feel that you can do so much. If I could put that clock back 70 or 80 years, I would have never have imagined that one day there would be a fax, a telex, a computer. We didn't even know what it was like. But you have the tools, you have the technology, you have the capacity to do so much better in this world. So much energy is spent on destroying this poor planet of ours. Let us devote more time on building it. And let us devote more time on education, because that is the cement, those building blocks of development. Education is what makes us become and do what we can and what we can do in the future and do in the present. Now, for instance, today, my biggest ambition, I still have ambitions, by the way. I haven't given those up. My ambition today is, before I get called to other functions elsewhere, to train some school teachers for Somaliland, because that is that cloud that will help me train to educate more children. So education, the training of teachers, that's the mission I want to achieve before I get called away. Nurses can take care of themselves. They don't need me anymore. Nurses have a status. I'm not worried about midwives. By the way, I had a goal to train 1,000 midwives for Somaliland. But today, yesterday, I was told that we have reached the target of 938 and 600 are in training in different schools. So I have not only reached it, but I have done 150%. So if that can be done in Somaliland, it can be done everywhere. Women must be saved. Women can be saved with training, with education, with determination. And thank you also very much. Thank you for giving me for this opportunity to speak about the potential of human beings. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much to the iconic Edna Adam for such a positive and really powerful way to take us towards the end of what's been a truly magnificent day.
And to bring us to a fitting close, we'd like to reflect on today's many highlights with someone who inspired the entire goalkeepers movement.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the final time today, please welcome back Melinda Gates.
Up here. Well, what a great day it's been.
I can't even believe it. It's been incredible.
Yeah.
And I'm just wondering, it's been an amazing 24 hours really since yesterday, but what are the moments that have really stood out for you?
Well, I think last night, starting with the award winners, to see what they could do in their communities, whether that was Dismas or Nadia, they remind us why we're here and what these goals are about. And then today, to see some of the change agents, Edna, DJ Switch this morning, who inspired all of us, President Macron, who stepped into this leadership role in just such a powerful way. It was, I would say, these 24 hours have been even more than we could have imagined for.
And at the end of today, specifically, what do you want these goalkeepers to take home? What's your parting message for them?
Well, I want them to take home that this is going to take more than just what happened in the room today, and it's your energy and your inspiration that are going to move these goals forward. Progress is possible, but it's not at all inevitable. And we, the older generation, learn and are inspired by you. We're here behind you, but we're incredibly excited to see the extraordinary things and the work that you will do ahead.
Thank you so much.
Melinda, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that's actually it. Goalkeepers 2018 is over, or at least it is in here. But out there in the atrium, we'd love you to keep talking, keep connecting, and start that process of making change happen.
And to keep the energy up, we're going to end this day with a track very special to all of us, to everyone, by the late, great Aretha Franklin, Respect. And there's only one person who we could have invited back to push the button on that, right? DJ Switch Ghana is back, everyone.